ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's performance by Newsboys. The band will take the stage in approximately 1 minute.
Love. been waiting all day, like little kids in a candy store, to get out here on stage and give Portland some rock and roll. So much in Nashville, we have a coffee shop, my favorite coffee shop, called Portland Brew. Y'all got it going on out here. Love you, love you, love you. I can come and hug all of you and kiss you on the cheek, I'd do it, but I can't. Please welcome to the stage tonight, one of my besties. This man is married to one woman, thank the Lord. He has two beautiful girls. Oh, they're so sweet. And his wife is about to burst with their third baby girl. He is our handsome band director. Please welcome to the stage tonight the man where his last name really is his last name. Give it up for Mr. Jeff Frankenstein. Northwest for 4 or 5 days. What are your thoughts now? Our last night here, what are your thoughts?
Well, it's a shame that we have to go home tomorrow, but considering my wife is about to go into labor, I may need to go. I hate to leave you guys, but but I was thinking, you know, if worse came to worse and the baby, you know, came tonight, perhaps we'll name it Portland. Yeah, you know, perfect, you know, because they say keep Portland weird, you know, Portland Frankenstein.
That's good, that's good. Oh man, I must say, I have definitely got my quota of rain in. Yeah. Guys, somebody's my career. I want to go to Powell's and read books all day and drink coffee and sleep. Truth is, every little bit of sunny outside. I hope you like to see. Guys, we love it. We love it. Thank you for coming out. Enjoy bands tonight, like Family Force 5, Audio Adrenaline, my main hip hop man, Derek Milo. Here we go, Keith. The white guy with the muscles, what's his name? Jeremy Camp. Duncan Phillips, muscles. How you guys doing over here? Not bad. I love you. You love me? Yeah, thank you. Think about it. A lot of you guys saw a movie, God's Not Dead. And this is not April Fool's. But April the first, in every theater you saw movies like James Bond 007, or even more recently movies like Star Wars. Check this out. You are going to see our movie, God's Not Dead, Part 2, Nationwide. So take an unsafe friend, don't be cheap, buy them popcorn, and let them meet Jesus in a local theater. Just really quick, we'll keep singing, really quick. We're living in crazy times, guys, cray-cray times. Grandma said, honey, the world's going to hell in a handbasket. Truth is, we've been lost the handbasket. But as long as I live, hear this, Portland, I promise under God, as long as I live, if doing the right thing is considered wrong, then this chocolate brother right here, and those three banana brothers back there, we will be guilty all day long. Free. this up. In this time of desperation, all we know is doubt and fear. Same story. Listen, when Paris happened in the last year, those terrorists tore up Paris, guys, I feared for a minute. I know God's in control, but I'm still human. No excuse is a fact. Amen, but I prayed for Paris. Hey, when San Bernardino, Cali, just a little something there happened, my heart broke on our country. And the poor moms and dads. Oh, Jesus, help us. My heart beat again and broke again. And God knows the election. Jesus, help us. Of desperation, all a lot of us know is doubt and fear. But my Bible tells me, greater is he that's in me than all the devils in the world. People say, Newsboys. We got a little famous now. We're in a movie. We still can't act. You make a movie, everybody knows you are. Hey man, what you that movie made? You're the brother that movie made. That was in the movie itself. It's funny how people think you're famous. Because you're in a movie. Truth is, guys, here's the deal, guys. We ain't famous. We ain't rock stars. We ain't movie stars. We are four men saved by God's grace plus nothing. Here's what we believe. This is our creed. We believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that he conquered death. And we believe in the mighty supernatural resurrection. And we know he's coming back again. That's why we believe. Fear. Would you like some more? But first, please give me 2 seconds to say this, maybe 22 seconds. Guys, you've heard it said a million times, too many times, and it's true, Black Lives Matter. I got news for you, man. My Holy Bible says God created all men and women, so all lives matter. Every single life. I'm so sick and tired of race riots. You're this color, you're that color. It's time for a love riot. Amen? So tonight, if you pre-buy the record, comes out March the 4th, the movie April 1st, record March 1st, March 4th. Buy the record tonight, upstairs. We will give you a CD with 5 songs from that record on it. And let me tell you right now, it's not being caught, it's crazy God for his blessing, but it's the bomb record you need to get. You know, newsboys don't make no joke. So buy the record tonight. Me, Jody Davis, Duncan Phillips, Dr. Jeff Frankenstein, daughter named Portland. We'll sign autographs. We'll sign every CD you buy. We will sign your CD. We will not leave this building until you sign your CD. Cool? Now, one of Michael Tate's favorite songs on that record to sing is a little ditty called Crazy. So go crazy for it. Here we go.
Thank you. each of you. Set you fill in the papers I've just given you with three little words. God is dead.
I can't do what you want, Christian.
I can help you.
I'm Amy Lyon. I write the Love.
Okay, how are you?
So in a few minutes, you guys are going to go out there and you're going to sing about God and Jesus as if they're as real as you and me. How can you do that?
Well, to us, they are as real. As a matter of fact, even more so. I mean, we exist in the here and now. They've existed forever. Think about that.
Do you think you're smarter than me? Do you think there's any argument you can make that I don't have an answer for? I want to make this clear. In that classroom, there is a God in him. I'm him.
So I see. So when you're pressed, you quote a bunch of ancient scribblings and say, don't worry, it's all in there.
Well, they may be ancient, but they're not scribblings. We believe God gave us an instruction manual, and it's where we draw our strengths, where we find our hope.
Science supports his existence. You know the truth. So why do you hate him? It's a very simple question. Why do you hate God?
I think you're here kind of wondering, kind of hoping that this stuff is for real.
I didn't know that.
I just felt that that's what God was saying. I just wanted you to know. It's...
He's just the drummer.
Me and the gang want to let you know, we've heard in the news that there's been a bit of a squabble down there on campus. One of your professors insisted